MM810 News, it's Taco Tuesday. Oh my gosh, it's Taco Tuesday and I really need a taco, so I will travel to the taco stand in my raffle copter. Swah 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 swah. What's up people, it is I, the almighty Microsoft's fam, here to read some Windows errors. Now, let's get this party started. Your hard drive suddenly passed away. Would you like to revive it with a bologna sandwich? Curse you, Scotty. You know that I ate your bologna sandwiches. Tucks the penguin wants to be friends. Except, no way in a million years. I don't want Linux. I want my Windows and my Windows only. Microsoft Anna wants to be your girlfriend. Do you wish to go on a date with her? Thanks, but no thanks. By the way, change the title bar. It's embarrassing. Windows is bored, so you will now downgrade to Windows 98. Wait, no, I don't want to end up in that useless operating system. Great, just great. Now I'm in something that's not what I want, Windows 98. Welcome to Windows 98. Click OK to continue. Oh great, not this again. It tells me to click OK, but the OK button cannot be pressed. Now I'm trapped. How could this day get any worse? Taco Taco Productions, eat a taco every day.
Well, it appears that Sam isn't here, so I guess I'll be reading the errors for now. Your computer has detected a missing file. Microsoft Sam.exe. Would you like to browse for the missing file? Absolutely, this show can't run without my good friend Sam, so I guess it's time for an adventure. Hello viewers watching this video. My name is AT&T Mike, and you may know me as the voice of the speaker announcer from BFDI, but I'm not here to talk about that. You see, my good friend, Microsoft Sam, suddenly went missing a few days ago. Right now, I am trying to find him, but everywhere I look, high and low, he still isn't there. Hey, what's this? Our signals have found Sam's locations in Windows 98. Do you want to downgrade your computer to find Sam? Absolutely, it's time to save Microsoft Sam, my long-lost buddy. Ah, what a lovely startup theme. How it could Sam hate this beautiful gem of an operating system? Windows Firewall does not want you to proceed. You must enter an RPG battle. Fine, let's get this over and done with. I'm getting tired of this. Time for the finisher. Yay, I won the battle. Congrats on your victory. You may proceed. Thank you.
Gosh, how long am I going to have to stay here?
Hey Sam, guess who?
Oh my gosh, Mike, how did you get here?
I was getting worried about you, but then Windows XP found your locations. Wow, that computer is a lifesaver.
Mike, we have no time to praise Windows XP for its good deeds. We have to hide. He's coming.
Who's coming?
Windows Firewall.
Oh, Windows Firewall.
Wait, you actually know about that guy?
Why yes, I do. I remember when I just got into Windows 98, when suddenly, an error appeared saying I had to fight Windows Firewall in order to proceed.
So, did you win?
No duh, Sam. If I hadn't won, would I be standing here right now?
No, you wouldn't. Oh no, it's Windows Firewall and it's going to attack us both.
Not if we can return to Windows XP.
What are you talking about, Mike?
Come with me.
You won't.
Just bring me back to Windows XP already. Finally, we are back at home.
Yes, we are back at home. I never want to go back to Windows 98 ever again. Windows 98 says, come back. Never in a million years, you useless operating system. Taco Taco Productions, eat a taco every day. Well, here goes another boring day.
Hey Sam, how's it going?
Oh, hey there Mike, what brings you here on this not-so-exciting Tuesday?
I just wanted to inform you about the next episode of Windows Errors.
Oh my gosh, I completely forgot about those errors.
Well, what are we waiting for?
Let's roll. How's it going everyone? It is Eyes. Microsoft Sam, and today, I am here with my good friend AT&T Mike.
Hello viewers out there. Today we have a very special episode of Windows Errors. We made some improvements to the show, and we would like for you guys to enjoy this new style of Windows Errors. So, Sam, would you mind explaining the improvements to the show?
It would be my pleasure to do so. As you guys may have noticed, the two of us are appearing on screen at the same time. There is also a background, which is MM810 News Headquarters, the interior of it, that is. In previous episodes, there was no background, and only a single character would appear on screen at a time. Is that all I have to say?
I believe so. By the way viewers, for this episode exclusively, we will be borrowing Tree's computer.
Apparently, our own computer got infected by a nasty virus.
So, with all of that out of the way, let the show begin. Well, everything seems perfectly normal right now.
Object OS was unable to start up. You must restart your computer. Are you kidding me? This is the most stupidest error I've ever seen in my life. The computer started up normally, and now it's saying that it failed to do so. This causes so much frustration.
Oh well, let's just restart this computer.
Thank goodness that's over.
Object OS does not support keyboards. Press Enter to continue. But you just said that keyboards weren't supported.
Let me yank the keyboard.
Oh my gosh, Sam, you just yanked the keyboard off of Tree's computer.
He won't mind, I'm sure of it. Object OS wants cake. Please splat your piece of cake on the screen. Okay, seriously, why the heck would a computer, of all things, want cake? It won't even be able to eat it. It makes no sense at all. Oh, by the way, Tree's computer, I had no cake.
Object OS cannot stand listening to rants that are longer than 10 seconds. That is why your computer will blow up in 1 minute. Oh, Sam, how could you? Did you really have to make a rant?
Yes, I did have to make a rant, Mike. The computer was being stupid. But now we have to escape. Well, that certainly was a major explosion. The entire building has been destroyed.
At least we are okay. However, the question is, how will we tell Tree that we destroyed his computer?
Hey! What did you two ding-a-lings do to my computer?
No.
This is not good.
Taco Taco Productions, eat a taco every day. These injuries are going to take a very long time to heal. Ow, my back.
You think that's bad enough? I had to get a full body cast, because a certain something just had to beat the living daylights out of me.
And we all know who that certain something is.
Me!
How's it? Ow, going? Ow, everyone? Ow. Mike, would you mind taking over? My back is seriously killing me.
Anything for you, Sam? Last time on Windows Errors, we somehow managed to destroy Tree's computer, but what you didn't see was us getting pummeled to dust. Trust me, it was pretty brutal. Pesky inanimate objects aside, our computer is finally virus-free.
Well, everyone, as long as my back doesn't hurt me anymore, I should be ready to go.
So, with all of that out of the way, let the show begin.
The operation completed successfully. What?
MM810 News. The 2015 Taco Festival has been cancelled due to the incident from this year's Taco Festival. I really don't know what this is about.
Just stay silent, Sam, and maybe he won't notice.
I heard that.
You have received one new message. Would you like to open the email? Sure, why not? You fool. This was a scam. Fa 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 fa.
Here's a video, just for you two. Okay?
Windows has detected that Tree has placed a bomb near your house as a revenge scheme. Would you like to panic right now? No way. It's time to save ourselves. Congrats. Thanks to your heroic braveness, you didn't do anything to the bomb at all. Bye-bye. Wait, what the? This is too bad. I will get you for someday just to be messy.
Protect me, sir.
So much pain.
So little help.
Well, I hope you two know what happens when you destroy my computer.
And I hope you know what happens when you try to kill us.
Excuse me?
Taco Taco Productions, eat a taco every day. So, Mike, how's your body doing?
It's doing good so far. Just a bit of stiffness here and there.
Oop, let me get the door. I'll be back shortly, Mike. Hello. How may I help you?
Stop right there, mister. You have the right to remain silent.
What the? Who the heck are you? What in the world is going on here?
Simple. You're under arrest for stealing over 100 tacos from the 2014 Taco Festival.
Oh, come on. That old thing from last year. How come it took you guys months to find me?
Never mind that. The point is, you're under arrest.
Say, what's going on out there?
Ow.
Oh my gosh, Rich, what are you doing here?
Mike, you live with this man.
Yes, I do in fact live with Microsoft Sam. What are you going to do about it?
Guess this means I now have two people to arrest.
Haha, like you would be able to arrest me along with Sam. Well, guess we've both ended up in jail.
Hey, at least our cell has a computer. You know, This would be a great time to read some Windows errors.
Great idea, Sam. Let's start reading some errors.
By the way, viewers, no more recaps. Now on to the errors. Welcome to jail. You should be ashamed for what you have done. Oh, come on. Do you even know how hard it is to pass up over 100 tacos? Nom nom nom.
AT&T Rich says, you're stuck here for one day. Fine, at least it wasn't more than that.
Ugh, these errors are already getting boring. Let me put in my flash drive full of random Windows errors. You just infected this computer with a lot of random errors. Have fun. Alright, where do we start?
Windows is confused. It can't seem to tell the difference between a rock and a potato. Well, you see, it's actually pretty easy to...
Tux the Penguin would like for you to play with him on Animal Jam. What? No. Just no. I'm not doing that. That's stupid.
Why is this error blank?
Stop. Hammer time. No, it's not hammer time. It's rafflecopter time. Swah 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 swah.
Windows is having some issues. This is because its hard disk has been replaced with a buzzsaw. Last time I checked, Tux was not very good at fixing our own computer.
Stop right there, misters. If you don't take out that flash drive of yours right now, you will be stuck here for another day.
Fine. I'll take it out.
Good. Now both of you get some rest. Your trial will be held tomorrow.
All right, Mike. Let's just go to sleep. I can't stand this AT&T rich guy anymore. I just hope that our penalty isn't very significant.
Good day, everyone. My name is AT&T Mel.
Geez, how many of these AT&T guys are there?
I would like to present to you all the judge of this trial, Mario.
Okay, court is now in session. So, Mr. Microsoft Sam, you have been accused of stealing over 100 tacos, correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
How do you plead, sir?
Guilty, Your Honor.
Then it is settled. Microsoft Sam is in fact guilty of stealing over 100 tacos. As such, he will receive a punishment, which is... a $500 fine.
Well, that's it. It's all over. We've lost our entire budget. Mike, tell the viewers about the cancellation of Windows errors. We're done for.
However, there is a twist. As some of you may already know, the reason why AT&T Mike is here is because he was arrested by AT&T Rich alongside Microsoft Sam simply because he lived in the same house as him. Well, what AT&T Rich didn't know was that what he did was illegal under this land's law.
Yeah, just get on with it.
As such, he will also receive a punishment, which is... $1,000 directly to Microsoft Sam and AT&T Mike.
Hey, Mike, best we got luck at its finest today. Home sweet home, just how I like it.
Say, that looks like an error message.
Congratulations for being able to continue this series. What do you know? For once our computer is actually showing us a good error message.
By the way, Tux sent you a request to be his buddy on Animal Jam.
What? Taco Taco Productions, eat a taco every day. Mike, do you have any idea what we can do with our new budget?
Well, I'm not really sure what we could spend it on. I mean, there's not really much we can improve on Windows errors.
Good point. Well, I guess that we can save all of the money for a possible makeover to the series in the future. Hello viewers, welcome back to another episode of Windows Errors. As usual, I am Microsoft Sam.
And I am AT&T Mike.
So, now that we are both out of jail, we can read all of the Windows errors that we desire. We already have our computer booted up, so let's start right away. The MSN Butterfly would like to take you on a magical flying journey. May I ask where exactly this butterfly would take me? Oh. Well, then no.
Internet Explorer is feeling lonely. This is because you haven't used it in over 2 years. And I still don't plan on using it anytime soon.
Windows says, remember when you were sent to Windows 98? Yes, I do remember that. It was horrible. Don't ever remind me of that again.
Windows has detected that you have not sent your apology letter to the Taco Festival staff for stealing over 100 tacos. Send it now. Sam, you might want to do that right about now.
Seriously? In the middle of the episode? Ugh. Fine. I'll send it. MM810 News. The Super Smash Bros. Brawl Snapshot Collection will finally start development. Yes. Finally. I can't wait to see this collection. It's been over a year since it was announced.
Windows has an idea for an error message. Okay, let's see it.
Tux is angry at you for not wanting to play with him and will not tamper with your hard drive. Oh no you won't. I'll shoot you down with my top secret army of rafflecopters. Oh look, here they come. You better run. Swah 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 swah.
Windows feels ashamed of its idea for an error message, and would like to repay by giving you this fortune cookie. Well, this is a nice offer and all, but there's one problem. The fortune cookie is virtual.
Yes, I have finally located the house. Now it is time to put my plan into action. Let the AT&T uprising begin.
What the? That's unusual. Windows has detected that it has been hacked. What? Is this really happening? Or is Windows just toying with us?
It's for real. Windows has really been hacked. What do you want to do? You better make a decision quick. Guess we'd better go to safe mode. Let me just reach for the mouse. What? I was too late. I didn't even get to touch the mouse.
Oh no. Now Windows is creating evilly malicious errors. Now deleting all contents in your local disk. Not the local disk. That contains System 32.
Now logging you off of Windows forever. What? Oh my gosh, now we won't be able to do anything with our computer.
You know what, Mike? I'm going to get to the bottom of this. I'm going to walk outside and see if there are any signs of a hacker nearby. Wait here while I go and search. What the? Hey, you. What do you think you're doing?
Seems that Sam has already found the hacker. Guess I'd better take a look for myself.
And may I ask what exactly do you mean by this so-called AT&T uprising?
Hey Sam, did you find out who the... Oh my... gosh.
Taco Taco Productions, eat a taco every day. Previously.
I have finally located the house. Now it is time to put my plan into action. Let the AT&T uprising begin.
What the? That's unusual. Windows has detected that it has been hacked. What? Is this really happening?
It's for real. Windows has really been hacked.
You know what, Mike? I'm going to get to the bottom of this. Wait here while I go and search. What Okay, you. What do you think you're doing? And may I ask, what exactly do you mean by this so-called AT&T uprising?
Hey Sam, did you find out who the... Oh my... gosh.
And now, our feature presentation.
No, it can't be.
Oh yes it can be. Hello, Mike, long time no see.
Ray, I thought you were stuck in jail for the rest of your life.
Oh, let me guess. Another AT&T guy.
Well, yeah, AT&T Ray.
Well, Mike, for your information, I managed to escape prison just a short while ago. Even AT&T Rich had no chance of stopping me. Anyways, the reason I escaped is because I want revenge. Long ago, I threatened to destroy you, Mike, and all the other AT&T voices, because I was completely ignored. I never received any attention from you people, and I was always an outcast from social gatherings. It was like the entire world could have cared less about me, and ultimately, I felt neglected. Eventually, I got so fed up with your ignorance that I fought back by attempting to destroy all of your insignificant lives. Unfortunately for me, however, you all foiled my plans and reported me to the police, who arrested and sentenced me to life in prison.
Yes, that is a day I could never forget.
Oh, but I must correct you, Mike, because soon you will completely forget that memory and every other memory you've ever had. You see, during my time in prison, I've been plotting my ultimate revenge scheme, which I call the AT&T Uprising. Basically, for quite some time now, my top secret laboratory has been building a giant doomsday machine that, when activated, will brainwash and mind control every AT&T voice in existence.
Oh no, please don't do this, Ray. I beg of you.
Too late, Mike. I've already set my plan into action.
But Ray, just hear me out.
Moving on, there is another important part to my revenge scheme. Not only will my machine mind control every AT&T voice in this universe, but it will also terminate and destroy every non-AT&T voice from the face of this planet. And if you haven't already guessed by now, Sam, that includes you.
Oh no way, Jose. You will never terminate me, nor will you ever brainwash Mike.
Sorry, Sam, but you will not have your way, for my plan is already nearing completion.
What? Impossible.
Wrong, Sam. Before you even know it, my plan will become a reality, and I will be liked by everyone in the world.
Please just listen to me, Ray. You don't have to do this.
Oh, but I must, Mike. I must have the appreciation I never received long ago from you ignorant lowlifes. Now if you'll excuse me, I must teleport back to my top secret laboratory to finish my doomsday machine.
Wait, you can't-
Good luck trying to find me, Mike and Sam. I know you two will most certainly fail.
Darn, he got away. Mike, we need to find AT&T Ray and stop him from brainwashing the entire text-to-speech universe.
But Sam, how in the world are we ever going to find him? I mean, he just teleported himself to his top secret laboratory.
Easy. We'll just take a flight in one of my rafflecopters and see if we can find Ray's laboratory from above. I'm pretty sure we have a good chance of finding him that way.
Well, I guess that doesn't seem like a bad idea. Let's do it.
Alright then, Operation Uprising Prevention is a go. Now follow me to the rafflecopter, Mike.
So, Sam, where exactly do you think Ray could be?
Well, like he said, his laboratory is top secret, so Ray could be hiding just about anywhere. Now let's see what's down below. No, that's the jail that AT&T Ray escaped from. He couldn't possibly be hiding down there. No, that's just a generic taco stand. Although, I could really go for a taco right about now.
Sam?
Oh right, sorry. Well, isn't that just convenient? There's AT&T Ray's top secret laboratory, hidden in plain sight. You know, for a guy with a rather elaborate doomsday plan, he sure couldn't have made his quote, top secret laboratory more obvious. Alright, let's land this rafflecopter.
Well, here we are. Now let's see how we get inside.
I suspect that door over there would be our easiest option.
Wait, what's this? Oh, I see. We need a password to gain access.
Well, that could be a number of different things, such as maybe, taco. Darn, incorrect. How about, evil?
What about, doomsday?
Rafflecopter.
AT&T Uprising.
System 32.
Hacker.
Okay, I give up. Paul, Sam, and Mike will never guess this ridiculously long password. Wait, that seriously worked? I'm speechless. Well, no matter. It's time to finally put AT&T Ray back in his place. Come on, Mike.
Did that really just happen? It's quiet. Too quiet.
It's also too dark to see anything. Where could Ray possibly be hiding?
I'm over here, Sam.
What? Ray, is that you? Show yourself, and turn in a light for crying out loud.
Well, if you insist.
Oh my.
I must say, you two look pretty dumbfounded from up here.
Yeah, I guess you could say that. So this is your doomsday machine, Ray.
Affirmative, Mike. This is the result of many months of sophisticated automation to create the ultimate revenge weapon.
Right. So, what exactly is this so-called automation, and why can't I seem to find it anywhere inside this lab?
Oh, they were simply robot servants that I myself built secretly all those years ago. They were certainly instrumental to the fruition of my plan, but I had no use for them anymore, so I simply destroyed them all after I escaped prison.
Hold on 1/60th of a minute, how are you not even fazed at the fact that we managed to locate and break into your laboratory?
Yeah, what's up with that, you psychopath?
Hisk, I thought you half-wits would get the idea by now, but apparently I thought wrong. Do you not understand? I am so confident in my ingenious plan, that not even your very presence before me can possibly hinder my assurance of its success. With that said, you better say goodbye to your pathetic world as you know it, because in just 5 minutes, my glorious doomsday machine will be activated. You, Sam, will perish into nothing, and you, Mike, will live under my control. Everyone will live under my control, my vision, my world.
Not if Mike and I are still here, will your delusional mind get away with this?
Oh, that's what you think, but alas, I still have my teleportation device with me, so if you want even a sliver of a chance at victory, you better catch me quick.
What? Where'd he go?
I don't know. There he is. What the?
Now he's gone again.
Ignorant fools, you should have seen this coming from a mile away. But you didn't, and now I pity you.
Darn. Time's running out, and he keeps darting all over the laboratory.
And all we can do is move aimlessly, as he keeps teleporting everywhere.
See? Now you finally understand the big picture. You can try and stop me, but as you can clearly see, it is far beyond impossible. So why even bother trying, when I have this much of an advantage?
Ow, jeez.
Oh no, Mike.
Oh no, I'm trapped.
Ow.
Well, looks like this is where the road finally ends. I must admit, for a couple of jokers, you and Mike both were admirably stubborn. I like that. Regardless, of course, you have failed in your hopeless endeavor. Your fate is permanently sealed. This world is now mine for the taking. I will finally have my-
You're just stalling for time, aren't you?
Shut up, simpleton. I don't need your inferior judgment anymore. Any last words, Microsoft Sam?
So this is it. The fate of the entire universe in our hands. Against an evil maniacal tyrant, intent on the complete control of the entire text-to-speech universe. And we were no match. Absolutely none. Is what I would be saying, if you knew of my secret power.
What? What is this nonsense that you speak of?
Well, Mr. Big Bad Ray, you clearly underestimate the great power of the almighty Microsoft Sam. Allow me to put it into layman's terms, without any sort of embellishments. My rafflecopter goes...
What the heck? No, my glorious machine.
Well, that certainly went a lot smoother than I anticipated. Oh, look at that. The evil menace weighing over his head has been trapped and defeated. Ha 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 ha. If that just isn't karma, then I don't know what is. So this is your fancy little getaway, ain't it? Guess you wouldn't mind now, if I took this from you. As well as your pesky teleportation device.
Hey Sam, see if you can find a way to get me out of this cage.
Oh yeah, of course Mike. Hold still for just a second.
Hooray, I'm free. Well, I guess we did it. We saved the text-to-speech universe.
Indeed, we did just that, Mike. Now no one has to worry about any sort of mind control or brainwashing.
Or termination, in your case.
Shut up, Ray. You've already been defeated. Besides, it's back to jail, for you anyway.
Don't think you'll be able to escape so easily next time, mister.
This isn't over, you hear me? I will undoubtedly have my revenge, in due time at least.
Ahem, mister, you have the right to remain silent. So, Mike, no hard feelings about me arresting you and Sam, that while ago, right?
Oh, that, well, I actually kind of forgot that even happened, so yeah, we're on good terms now.
Good, then we can all move on peacefully with our normal day-to-day lives.
Except for Ray, of course.
Easy there, mister.
Okay, fine. I spent a lot of that night pondering all of the day's events. How strange was it that Mike and I would essentially become the saviors of the entire universe in less than 24 hours? What exactly led AT&T Ray into the psychotic downward spiral he's stuck in today? What all do I not know about the past of my good friend AT&T Mike? I thought these questions and many more throughout that evening, but I couldn't quite come up with definite answers to any of them. People say that everything happens for a reason. Well, if that's the case, then you also can't really find an explanation for every one of those reasons either. But maybe it's for the best. Maybe we don't need an explanation to everything. After all, like anything else in the world, life continues and goes on.
Oh look, an error message.
Windows has received an email from Mario Master 810. Would you like to open it?
I'm pretty sure that must be something important, Sam.
You're probably right, Mike. Let's see what exactly the old boss sent us. Dear Sam and Mike, I want to personally thank you guys for your tremendous cooperation over these last 6 years. Microsoft Sam and AT&T Mike read Windows errors would certainly not be the same without you two. Episode 7 has been a video over 4 years in the making, and I'm so glad to finally be able to release it to all my viewers, especially those who've been fans of my channel since before 2017, when the series was still being regularly produced.
The Windows Errors series is one that I will always hold close to me, as the first major long-running series I have ever produced on this channel. Without a doubt, I had tons of fun making some of these episodes. Looking back at them now, they really do remind me of much simpler times on this platform, back when I was an extremely small creator just doing my own thing. Call me sentimental, but those are memories that I will always cherish.
Unfortunately, however, I can no longer beat around the bush. This is officially the end of Microsoft Sam and AT&T Mike Read Windows Errors. Right here, at Episode 7. Believe me, I really wanted to continue this series, but if it wasn't obvious before, that ship has long past sailed. If there's any silver lining to this, I guess, now that I'm finally retiring Windows Errors, I'm also finally closing the chapter that is my old days on YouTube, so there's that.
Despite taking practically forever to finally release Episode 7, I wasn't about to break that promise I had made so long ago. Somehow, someway, it was going to get done, and now it feels great to fulfill that promise at last. I truly am satisfied now that it's all finished.
To all the viewers watching this video, especially my veteran fans, I hope you all enjoyed the show. And to Sam and Mike, thank you both so much for the work you have done to make Microsoft Sam and AT&T Mike Read Windows Errors so special. I hereby relieve you two of your services to this channel, and I wish you two the very best in the future. Sincerely, Mario Master 810. Well, it pains me to say this, but I guess it's finally time to close up shop. This is Microsoft Sam.
And this is AT&T Mike.
And for the very last time, we are signing off. Thank you so much for watching Microsoft Sam and AT&T Mike read Windows errors.
It's been a fun ride, everyone.